Hello everyone, welcome back. I was recently asked again why we at Science Denier Hall of Shame continue to do this, to make videos, to maintain the website, our Facebook page, why we're active on Twitter. And let me see what's playing behind me. That's where we need to be. The only thing that can get in our way is this growing anti-science trend that we've all been noticing, where people seem to prefer religion to science, conspiracy theory to actual learning. If this continues, this could derail any possibility of ending up out there. And honestly, the Earth has a finite lifespan. We need to be somewhere else before it reaches the end of that finite lifespan. Anyway, let us proceed. Today's video is, just ever so interesting. It's the Ice Wall of Stupid. Here we go.
Stinky Cash once again. And real quick, I want to address the idea of the ice wall. And when we say the ice wall, what we mean by that, a lot of the people who are skeptical are saying, if there's this great ice wall, how come there's no pictures of it? Well, there are hundreds, if not thousands, of pictures of the ice wall. So I think there are some misconceptions about what we mean.
I don't see how there can be any misconceptions. It seems quite clear. If we're talking about an ice wall, we would expect to see, a wall made of ice. And folks asking for pictures of it, I don't find that very unreasonable.
I mean, myself and other flat earthers, when we use the term ice wall, which is the wrong term to use, all we mean is the coast of Antarctica.
So why do we need a new name for it? I mean, why didn't we just call it the coast of Antarctica? Also, you say myself and other flat earthers as if there's some sort of consensus. There isn't. It seems like various flat earthers describe different things in different ways, and there doesn't seem to be any sense of agreement.
And there are pictures of the coast of Antarctica and the Antarctic shelf all over the internet.
That there are. What's your point?
We're not talking about the exterior part of Antarctica. We're talking about the coast.
The exterior part is the coast, as seen in this photo from space. You know, the continent of Antarctica, where this happy fellow is standing, at the geographic South Pole. All right, let's hear more about this ice wall.
I think it averages maybe a half mile high.
Remember what I said about the flat earthers not being able to agree with each other? Here's a quote from the Flat Earth Society webpage, which indicates that the ice wall is 150 feet high. Hardly a half a mile.
This is the container that holds the world's oceans in.
No, no matter how many times you say it, it's still just the periphery of a continent.
Water always levels out and always takes the shape of its container. This model has level water and a container.
It's not a model, it's a picture. A model makes certain references to the object it is referring to and how it functions. This is just a picture. As such, it allows any flat earther that uses it to say anything he wants about it. You know, like a confused description of the fact that water seeks its own level, and that it's a container. All right, now let's hear more about Antarctica.
Which is the Antarctic continent that surrounds us. It's not on the bottom of the ball. It's actually the ice that surrounds us and holds the oceans in.
I'm pretty sure we covered that already. Antarctica is a continent. It is a land mass, covered with ice, surrounded with water. You know, like this. You see, we not only have a map of the area, we also know how thick the ice is and what's under it. It's these details describing the continent that make it a little more convincing than it's a wall surrounding the oceans.
That's scientific. Level water, container.
Okay, geologists, cartographers, earth scientists in general, y'all can go home now. Apparently it's all been figured out. We don't need you anymore. Can all go home. Good night.
The globe has curved water sticking to the outside of a ball with absolutely no container.
Okay, I'm pretty sure we covered this in a previous video. The water is not sticking to a spinning globe. The water is held in place by gravity, which draws it downward towards the center of gravity, just like the atmosphere is.
There's probably nothing. There's no wall. There's no glass dome. You're not going to find anything. If this model is true, the further you go towards the exterior of Antarctica, the further you go away from the center, the further you're going to be away from the sun.
Now, I know we already covered the fact that this is not a model. This is a picture about which one can say anything one wants while holding it up. Ooh, and there's that reference to moving away from the sun. The sun, apparently, in this model, moves in a circular path centered around the North Pole. No mechanism has been disclosed as to what keeps it moving in a circular path. The theory of gravity explains the mechanisms for the movements of all objects in the solar system, and beyond, really. But of course the Flat Earthers will have none of that, denying the existence of gravity and all. One interesting thing about the theory of gravity, as it applies to this discussion, is that it precludes the possibility of a large object moving in a circular path unless it's caught in the gravity well of an even larger object. So the sun moving in a circle overhead is not possible.
Which means it's going to start getting extremely cold and extremely dark. And eventually you're going to go so far that you reach absolute zero temperatures and absolute darkness. It's a natural barrier.
What's amazing here is that someone can speak with such an air of authority on a topic about which they have no information whatsoever.
Absolute zero temperatures and absolute darkness. And snow and storms and wind all around you. What are you going to do when you get all the way out there? There's going to be nowhere to go. You're not going to be able to do anything. There's nothing there. It's nothingness.
Was there some sort of Flat Earther expedition to this area that I have not heard about? Perhaps satellite imagery? I'm strongly suspecting that these are just more assertions without evidence. And we know what can be done with assertions without evidence. This famous quote by Christopher Hitchens is probably a good thing to keep in mind whenever listening to any of the assertions made by the Flat Earther crowd. That about wraps it up. I think it's just about perfect to end with a quote from a man of logic and reason. Well, once again, thank you for watching. And if you like what we're doing here at Science Denier Hall of Shame, please remember to like and subscribe below.